What's going on, everyone? In this video, I'll be going over the digital SAT English exam and walking you guys through it. So let's get right into it. Guys, so let's go through these problems and get 100% because that's what we're here for, all right? Hundreds only. So as Mexico's first president from indigenous community, Benito Juarez became one of the most blank figures in his country's history. Among the many significant accomplishments of his long tenure in office, so he did this and he did this. Okay, so already I'm seeing that they're trying to say that Benito Juarez, right, is a great man. He's done something great. So we need to find a word that resembles great or important or influential, right? So ordinary, no. Unpredictable, no. Important, secretive. Nothing is saying he's being secretive at all, right? Only important. So important it is. Pretty simple question, guys. Again, it's talking about how he's very significant, right? And significant, important, same thing. So pretty straightforward. Due to their often strange images, highly experimental syntax, and opaque subject matter, many of John Ashbery's poems can be quite difficult to blank, and thus are the object of heated debate among scholars. So it looks like that this guy's poems are pretty hard to understand, right? That's what I get from reading this sentence. Completes the text with the most logical and precise word or phrase. All right. Many of John Ashbery's poems can be quite difficult to what? Delegate, no. Compose, no. Compose means you're writing it, right? Interpret, right? If people are having debates, right? Heated debates, everyone's having their own interpretation, right? That's what you really have to think about when you're reading these types of questions is think about the real world, okay? In the real world, if you're having a sort of heated discussion, it's because there's multiple perspectives on the thing. If there's multiple perspectives and people are saying the subject matter is opaque, highly experimental syntax, it sounds like it's kind of hard to understand. The Cambrian explosion gets its name from the sudden appearance and rapid diversification of animal remains in the fossil record about 541 million years ago during the Cambrian period. Some scientists argue that this blank change in the fossil record might be because of a shift in many organisms to biotypes that are more likely to be preserved. Okay, so basically a bunch of rapid diversification happened, okay? Why? Some scientists argue that this catastrophe changed the fossil record. So this isn't really a catastrophe. Like this isn't a catastrophe. It's just saying that, hey, a lot of diversity is going on, which if anything is pretty good. Elusive means no. That there's no way elusive can fit in this, right? Because it's basically saying all of a sudden, right? Sudden appearance, rapid diversification. This is all like, happening all of a sudden, like out of nowhere. It's abrupt, right? So C is the answer, abrupt. Because it's like you're not expecting it. It came out of nowhere, abrupt. During 2014 archaeological dig in Spain, Vicente Lowe and his team uncovered the skeleton of a woman from El Algar, an early bronze ancient society, buried with valuable objects, seemingly a high position of power. Okay, so they found some cool stuff, basically. That's all I'm getting. Sometimes when you have this text that's like, you like has all these, you know, cool things, like these cool names and early bronze ancient society, you want to dumb it down for your mind. All right, dumb it down for yourself. In my opinion, what I get from this is cool, right? Cool things. That's it. They found some cool stuff. This finding may persuade researchers who have argued that Bronze Age societies were ruled by men to blank that women may have also held leadership roles. Okay. Basically, this woman, right, has power. Okay, woman has power, right? And that means that men have to accept the fact that women may have also held leadership roles. So persuade researchers who have argued that Bronze Age societies ruled by men to waive, concede, refute. No, it's not refute. It's not require. It's not waive. Waive means like let it go. It's concede, right? Which basically means that, all right, I give up. You're right. Women also were powerful. They also had leadership roles, right? Because it's saying that these researchers were arguing that the Bronze Age societies ruled by men. But now, based on this evidence right here, they're saying, okay, you got it. We concede. And if you don't know what concede means, you're just going to have to do process elimination. Waive means, like, you know, like, move off. Refute is, like, go against. Require just doesn't make sense, so concede. All right, now we're trying to go a little faster. Within billion real species, some individuals develop an accessory spleen. All right, so develop some cool stuff, basically. Given the formation's greater prevalence among whales known to make deeper dives, some researchers hypothesize that its role isn't blank. Rather, the accessory spleen may actually support dive mechanisms. So it's basically saying that, hey, the accessory screen is active, right? It's useful. It's needed. It's not what you think it is. So it's not what? Replicable? No. Predetermined? No. It's not latent. Latent means like not in use, calm, like not really, not calm. It's not in use. Right? It just, it's idle. People think it's functionless, right? But it's not functionless, guys. It has a function. It's not latent. All right, it's active. So that's the giveaway. According to a U.S. tax policy expert, state taxes are blank. Other factors when considering an interstate move. Even significant differences in state taxation have almost no effect on multiple decisions, while differences in employment opportunities, house availability, climate are strong influences. So these are strong influences right here. Okay. So it looks like taxes don't mean anything. Taxes are baked, right? No one cares about taxes. So they're pretty irrelevant. So, which is kind of crazy because personally, I hate taxes. I don't want you guys, but yeah. According to U.S. tax policy experts, state taxes are irrelevant to other factors when considering interstate move, which is true because these are the factors that matter and tax does not. Tax is useless. IRS, don't hurt me. The author's claim about the relationship between and Homo sapiens is blank as it fails to account for several recent archaeological discoveries. To be convincing, his argument would need to address recent finds of additional hominid fossils. So basically, they're saying that this guy's claim about the relationship between them is not complete because it's not incorporating all this extra stuff right here. So we will say, this is kind of hard, right? Disorienting means like out of order. This isn't really out of order. New, unoriginal, I would say it's saying that he's copying off someone. It's more that it's not complete. Tenuous and nuanced. I know what nuance means. Nuance means there's some things you got to consider. Tenuous, I do not know what it means. But since I do know what nuance means, I do know what nuance is like, hey, you know, there's some context, right? There's some things you want to consider. It seems like this can fit because saying that this guy's claim is nuanced, but it's not addressing everything. So, yeah, I'm going to go with nuanced. Okay. The following text is from Georgia Douglas' poem, which states the main purpose of the text. Go forth, my son, win by my heart's desire, great reaches yet unknown, away for a position, I may not if I would, retrace away with you, my pilgrimages through, life is calling you. It looks like the mom is saying, go, my son, go live freely, go be great. Express hope that a child has the same accomplishment as his parent did. Suggest that raising a child involves many struggles. What? No. To warn a child that he will face many challenges throughout his life. Yeah, so I think it's not that. It's not, the person's not saying, I want you to be with me, right? Because she's saying, my pilgrimage is through, like, I'm done, but life is calling you, go for it. So it's more like she's encouraging a child to embrace the experiences life will offer. And see how I formulated my opinion before I read the choices? It helps you narrow down, pick the right answer, like, almost immediately. Okay, so we want to focus on the underlying text, all right? Now the woman began to test the trees, moving leisurely among them, axe hand, strike a quick blow to see the sap would appear. The trees, like people, have the individual characters, some are ready to yield up the lifeblood, while others are more reluctant. Basically saying that some trees were easier to get sap from, some were harder. Okay, so it does not portray the range of women, right? Now, one of the basin was set under each tree, and hardship driven deep in the cup, which the axe had made from the corner of the chip, first drop would drive them, and free the sap, trigger two little dishes. Okay, this part is really important. It's just saying that, you know, some of the trees were easier to get sap from, some were not. So the foreground's beneficial relationship between humans and maple trees. It's not really saying that, hey, this is how we work together. It's not saying it's how trees and humans work together, so no. It's not really saying how human behavior can be influenced by the natural environment because this line right here is just focused on trees. It's not really focusing on human behavior. So eliminate C as well, eliminate A. So I'll pick a D because it is talking about aspect of the maple trees, right? Some are easier, some are harder, right? And based on that, women have to evaluate that. So that whole aspect of the maple tree, this is what really gives it away for me, what really convinces me that this is the answer. Okay, and now we're on the text. So We'll see that in the next video. Thank you all for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. And now I'll see you guys next video. Check out my SAT reading course in the description below if you want to be able to decipher passages like this and get a perfect score on the reading exam. Peace.